going to play a song first. We're going to start with
it. Are you ready?
We're ready.
Of the color guard, like you try to plug or anything like that, just give them their face to them and send them on their way. They'll continue.
Correct.
It works. Okay. Yep. Great. All right. Cool. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Good evening and welcome to tonight's performance of Navy Band Great Lakes. I am Master Chief Musician Jay Luce. On behalf of Commander, Naval Service Training Command, Rear Admiral Craig Mattingly, and the Director of Navy Band Great Lakes, Lieutenant Commander Christopher Cornett, thank you for joining us. Tonight we have a unique show planned for you. Our Director, Lieutenant Commander Cornett, is on official travel to Washington, D.C. and will not be joining us tonight, so we get the rare opportunity to showcase our fine enlisted conductors. Our opening selection was Midway March by John Williams and was conducted by musician second class Stephen Lang. The Battle of Midway was a major U.S. victory and the turning point of the war in the Pacific. The key to American victory was breaking the Japanese encryption codes. John Williams references the stolen code in Midway March with a repetitive set of staccato notes throughout the piece. Color Guard, parade the colors. If you're able, please rise and welcome to the stage Chief Musician Cassie Hamilton to lead our national anthem. Thank you. Next selection is Second Suite in F for Military Band. Celebrated British composer Gustav Holst wrote and revised his two suites for military band during a time of immense compositional growth. Both suites were composed before the premiere of his symphonic masterwork, The Planets, which in many ways relied on his experience working with folk songs. The suite we bring to you tonight incorporates many folk melodies, including a dance, a love song, a working song, and lastly, another traditional dance tune combined with the familiar green sleeves. To conduct Holst's Second Suite in F, please welcome musician second class Joe McNure.
Joe McNorton. Our next piece is British Eve, a march written by Zoe Elliott during World War II and dedicated to the British 8th Army after a triumphant sweep across North Africa in 1942. Since the war, this impressive march has retained its popularity on both sides of the Atlantic. Please welcome Navy Band Great Lakes leading petty officer, musician first class Ed Reed, to conduct British 8th. Was completed in 1904 by Johannes Hansen, who served as the bandmaster of the Oslo Military Band from 1926 to 1934 and again from 1945 to 1946. Valdres was written to celebrate the beautiful Valdres region in Norway that lies between Oslo and Bergen. The main theme you will hear in the opening measures performed by a solo trumpet was borrowed from the signature fanfare for the Valdres Battalion. Please welcome musician first class Patrick Pedlar as he conducts Valdres March.
Thank you.
Each year, Navy musicians present over 6,000 performances across the United States and around the world, connecting with millions of people. Proud musical ambassadors, our 11 bands represent the Navy's finest, stimulating pride, esprit de corps, promoting national and international public relations, and enhancing the prestige of the Navy. Here at Navy Band Great Lakes, we support Naval Service Training Command's mission of transforming volunteers into 21st century sea warriors. We provide musical support to honor recruits, sailors, and their families as they graduate from recruit training. As the Navy's ambassadors to the Midwest, Navy Band Great Lakes performs for communities of all sizes across 11 states. Please search Navy Band Great Lakes on Facebook if you would like to find out more about us and where we're performing next. To showcase the variety of music our members perform, we would like to present Sing to the Moon. Written by Laura Mvula, this arrangement of Sing to the Moon was recorded by the popular music group Snarky Puppy. It was adapted specifically for Navy Band Great Lakes by our own musician first class, Zach Ellerbrook, who will also be conducting tonight. Please welcome to the stage musician third class, Sarah Vega, as we present Sing to the Moon.
Navy Band Great Lakes, and this band right here is called Horizon. We are the popular music group, and we do a lot of schools and public outreach to our communities, just like we're doing now. So we came here to put a smile on your face. Feel free to sing and dance if you want to. This is your party.
Yeah.
ourselves as we are.
Si es cuestión de confesar, no sé preparar café, ni entiendo de fútbol. Creo que alguna vez fui infiel, juego mal a estar parques y jamás uso reloj. Y para ser más franca, nadie piensa en ti. De lo mismo. Si es cuestión de confesar, nunca duermo antes de 10, ni me baño los domingos. Y la verdad es que también lloro una vez al mes, sobre todo cuando hay frío. Conmigo no eres vacío.
Music group Horizon, again, musician third class Sarah Vega, vocalist, under the leadership of musician first class Ed Mead. With this concert being led by all enlisted conductors, it is appropriate for us to recognize a special guest to the band this evening, Master Chief Petty Officer of the Navy, retired Jim Hurt. And I'm going to point him out before I read more about him. He's handsome gentleman over here in the pink shirt. The Master Chief Petty Officer of the Navy is the highest ranking enlisted member of the Navy and is appointed by the Chief of Naval Operations to advise the senior leadership of the Navy on all enlisted matters. As you know, the military loves its acronyms, and this office is commonly known as the MCPON. MCPON Hurt is a native of Casper, Wyoming. He served at sea on both aircraft carriers and submarines and held numerous senior enlisted leadership positions. His distinguished 36-year Navy career culminated in his service as MCPON from 1998 to 2002, and he is one of only 16 Master Chief Petty Officers to serve as MCPON since the office was established in 1967. Thank you for joining us this evening, Jim.
Citizen and defended by the same. That winter saw the foundation of what would become the greatest maritime force the world has ever known. Every American sailor from then until today represents a vital link in an unbroken chain, a chain forged by the sea. First to bear the title of American sailor. I arrived in Boston with nothing more than the clothes on my back, the skill in my hands, and the desire to serve. My shipmates and I wore mismatched uniforms and sailed a makeshift fleet, but we struck a mighty blow against the vaunted British Navy, helping to win our independence and ensure the promise of liberty for generations to come. The intervening centuries have seen sailors of every race, color, and religion united by the same fighting spirit, pulling on the same lines. We are aviators, doctors, and engineers. We are parents, spouses, and teachers.
Called upon by our nation, we have always risen to the challenge.
was The American Sailor, composed by chief musician Chris Buchanan, chief arranger of the United States Navy Band in Washington, D.C. Please, another round of applause for our conductor and leading chief petty officer, chief musician Diane Potts. And our narrator, musician second class, Kevin Anderson. Ladies and gentlemen, your United States Navy and our fellow servicemen and women from all branches of the armed forces owe a tremendous debt to those who came before us. They shaped our military into the most powerful fighting force the world has ever known, and in doing so, many have paid dearly for their service. Those who paid the ultimate sacrifice rest in military cemeteries around the globe, from Arlington, Virginia, to France, Italy, Germany, Tunisia, and more. Please join us in a moment of silence as we remember our fallen brothers and sisters.
Thank you.
recognize all of the veterans, their friends, and families in the audience tonight. If you or a member of your family has served, please stand proudly when you hear your service's song. The United States Air Force.
are worth every piece of chicken, right?
Yes, very much. Yeah, thank you so much.